Guild Expeditions, Battles and Rewards of Level 4. Due to the huge size of the topic, I produced 2 video clips. The path to level 4 is described in a previous video clip. This video clip only focuses on the battles and rewards of level 4. Again, using the postmodern era as an example. Already, a first look on the map showing volcanoes and streams of lava lets players foresee that this will be a difficult level. Players should reckon to have a serious battle already at the very first platform. I have a very good fighting bonus, but even with this, I am very serious with the first fight. You see that I no longer use the automatic fight feature. The computer not only provides 2 waves, it also has a bonus of 85% on attack and defense. As you recognize in the video clip, I do not have new hints or strategies for level 4. Using the same approach already explained in the previous video clip, I also have success here. But it is necessary to pay attention. Even small mistakes can lead to a complete failure. I lose 1 unit against wave 1, so I'm outnumbered against wave 2. In levels 1, 2 or 3, the computer only uses units of a single type. Example given, light units for the first platform. On level 4, this is different. But the mixture of heavy and light units also have an advantage for me. The heavy units run very fast towards my side, and so I can eliminate them first. Afterwards, I can concentrate on the slower light units. So I survive this wave without additional losses. It is very common to receive forge points as a reward, especially when you also consider the relics. At platform 2, I optimize my team for wave 1. Heavy units are excellent against fast units. It is my intention to bring a complete team to wave 2. Indeed, the battle brings no surprises. In the end, 2 units are a bit wounded, but the team is still complete. But now, my 4 heavy units and 4 rogues are facing heavy and light units. This is not the best mixture, so the second wave will not be that easy. It is a well-established strategy to remain in the starting position first, to let the opponent move into my range. I already emphasized this in the first clip. With 1 heavy unit, I'm not following that strategy, as it will not get into the opponent's range by moving forward. Afterwards, everything works as expected. Only the very last light unit makes some trouble. Hidden in a forest, I cannot attack it from the distance. The difficult terrain makes it difficult to reach that unit. This way, I receive a few more hits. The possible rewards of the second platform are either 20 goods or 4 more attempts. On the next platform, the computer adds another 5% to its fighting bonus. On top, it sends a wild mixture of all unit types. I decide for heavy units plus rogues. I avoid to make the same mistake the computer makes, sending a single unit isolated to the front. Instead, I keep my units together. This is still correct and important if you lose a possible shot by doing so. Due to this careful approach, I only lose a single unit against wave 1. Against wave 2, I again can eliminate the units which shoot ahead. So I am outnumbered only for a very short time. Now I have to move forward very fast to avoid to have the same problem with a unit hidden in the forest. Also, the opponent's artillery tries to hide in the farmost corner. On the other side, it is still important to keep the team together. I think that I found the right compromise. Platform 3 provides either diamonds or medals. Remember, lower levels always gave unbound units at this platform. It gets more and more concrete that level 4 provides much better rewards. And then there are still the relics. But this one I only can access if I previously succeed in some more battles. The first bigger platform again is harder than all before. But the procedure is just the same. The rogues receive the initial hits. The isolated units shooting ahead are eliminated first. I keep my team together but move forward quickly. With each battle, these are the same basics which lead to success. And winning against the first wave without losses, I call a success. Against the second wave, I first wait a bit. Units which would move into the opponent's range remain in their starting position. Afterwards, all units move forward as far as possible, so that I will not miss a possibility for a shot against the opponent's artillery in the farmost corners. It is important to plan targets in a way that even the slowest units have a possible target. This means not to attack the frontmost unit first. I can be happy with the result. Possible rewards are the Gate of the Sun God or Forge Points. The gates are medium quality decorations, especially in lower eras. Platform 5, this time, has a very difficult map. Sometimes it is better to waste an attempt to get a better map next time. But as I can afford to lose a few units and the attempt is consumed anyway. So I try it with that map and decide for the difficult path around that lake. As a result, I have many moves without the possibility to fire. Therefore, it is not a surprise that I lost 2 units in the end. Against wave 2, I use the remaining 2 rogues as decoy to motivate the opponent's units to shoot ahead. Then I can destroy these with all my units. As a result, both sides have at least the same number of units. Then it works pretty well. My units make a lot of damage and receive much less. In the end, the units hidden in the forest make some trouble, but it is still enough to win this. For the first platform after a big platform, the reward is Forge Points again, this time 5. the 6 platform attacks with fast units in wave 1. You already know my opinion from previous battles. Passing wave 1 without losses is the best prerequisite for wave 2. The best counter unit against fast units are heavy units. Therefore, I again use a combination of heavy units and rogues. But the result is worse than I expected. The fast units do not hit all rogues in their first move. As a result, I have less shots than planned, and so I receive more damage than expected. Wave 2 is a pure duel of heavy units. The fighting bonuses of both sides are not that different. Of course, having 4 rogues is better than having one more unit, but the video clip shows that it is not an easy task and it is very close in the end. But it is a victory, and only that is important. Once again, just like after platform 2, the possible rewards are either 4 attempts or 25 goods. On platform 7, we find a wild mixture of all units of the opponent's side. I prefer to send heavy units plus rogues against such teams. Let me repeat the usual recommendations, like keeping the team together and avoid single units to shoot ahead. On top, I have to add the recommendation to eliminate those units first which have a bonus against my heavy units. Heavy units of the postmodern era have an advantage on planes. But there are no planes in the center of the map, but I have to pass there to avoid moving long to reach the artillery in the end. In the end, there is a gap in the video material. Unfortunately, Flash crashed twice. Only a complete restart of the browser solved the problem. This can happen with Flash, especially if playing long without interruption. Fortunately, the battle is not lost in such a case, but can be continued where it was interrupted. The second wave will not bring surprises. I again eliminate light units first, because their damage against my tanks is much heavier than the hits from the artillery. Possible rewards of platform 7 are the same as for platform 3, diamonds or medals. To receive more than 200 diamonds per week through the guild expedition is not unusual. The second bigger platform of level 4 is an opportunity to show what artillery units are able to do. First, the opponent's tanks get destroyed, as the slow infantry will not reach my artillery soon. I take care that my artillery is not moving forward to keep the maximum distance to the opponent's units. The tavern bonus helps to make sure that 2 hits are enough to destroy one opponent. Without that bonus, and given my fight bonuses, I often need a 3rd hit. This would destroy the whole concept. As soon as the tanks are destroyed, the ranged units are the next target. These have a huge range but can be killed before they come closer to my artillery. As my artillery hits the ranged units outside of their range, I do not have to fear their contact retaliation that MG teams normally have. This results in completing wave 1 without a single wound. In wave 2, the opponent also has artillery only. Now it is important to eliminate exactly the one unit that can be stopped firing next. The correct order is the key to success. You can see that with mouse over. The target is highlighted at the bottom unit list. This way, I can see which target is best. I only lose 2 units in this battle. Possible rewards are 10 forge points or a production building, in my case, a car factory. On platform 9, I have to conquer 8 heavy units first and 8 fast units right after. I decide for MG teams, the ranged units. These are only best against wave 2, but have a huge disadvantage against the heavy units of wave 1. But with 6 rogues, I can use the advantage of MG teams. When the rogue is hit and changing to an MG team, it retaliates. This is a good compensation for their disadvantage against heavy units. In the end, several MG teams are wounded, but the team is still complete. Wave 2 then has the fast units, and the MG teams have all advantages on their side. This makes me optimistic. As the battle proves, it is enough to win. In level 4, it is not a shame to lose 6 units in a battle. It is InnoGames' intention to make these fights to be a real challenge. It is worth to keep in mind that MG teams and rogues are a very good combination. At this first platform after a big platform on level 4, the reward is forge points. This time I get 5. Again, I decide for heavy units plus rogues. I prefer this team against mixed opponent teams, like heavy units and artillery in this case. There are no surprises in this battle. I only want to emphasize that the heavy units have to shoot ahead to avoid losing a possibility to shoot on the opponent's artillery. The distance is really long. Against wave 2, I have to pay attention that I must not lose the single real unit before the first rogue is transformed. Beside that, wave 2 is not that difficult as my heavy units have advantages here. There are not many planes in the center of the map, but it is enough to win. Possible rewards are 30 goods or a medium-sized medal package. Wave 1 of platform 11 sends 8 MG teams against me. These are feared for their retaliation. But if they are hit from outside their range, there is no retaliation. Therefore, I again use 8 artillery units. Wave 2 then is not as simple but manageable. Unfortunately, my fighting bonus is not good enough to reliably destroy tanks with only 2 hits. I sometimes need a third shot. If I improve on this, this battle will be much easier. Possible rewards are either diamonds or medals. I again receive 50 diamonds. This is really a good motivation to succeed in the guild expedition every week. platform 13 again is a good opportunity to use the successful combination of MG teams and rogues. This battle does not require comments. I already explained the advantages of that combination before. Against wave 2, this team dominates again. I complete platform 13 of level 4 without losses. Did you think that this could be possible? And as always, at the first platform after a big platform, the reward consists of forge points, this time 10. When I have exactly 3 attempts left on a Sunday evening and still have to succeed on 3 platforms, I have to negotiate. To be honest, with the final platforms of level 4, I usually use more than only 1 attempt before I finally win. And as I wanted to provide the best result for my guild, I decided for the secure version. To use 10 diamonds for negotiations is not difficult if I won 200 before. Possible rewards at platform 14 of level 4 are either 35 goods or an extra large packet of supplies. I was not that happy to receive the supplies, but to be honest, overall I do not have a reason to complain. And beside that, there is another relic. With platform 15, I again have no reason to comment the negotiations. There is already a video clip dedicated to the topic "Negotiate better at guild expeditions." Just follow the link in the video clip. Again, the possible reward is either 50 diamonds or medals. The final platform 16 of level 4 is also solved quickly through negotiations. As my tavern fight bonus still was active, I could not use the tavern negotiation bonus. Possible rewards are a renovation kit or the Yathbel, a building producing something randomly, exactly like the wishing well. The players of the guild Käfig voller Helden, English Cage Full of Heroes, gave their very best but ended up to be second with 111.8%. Of course, if 3 of our members would not have been in holidays, but with 80 players, there are always some who are absent. Congratulations to the befriended guild Musketeers, also from the German word Noisil. They achieve a full percent better result. I have to commit that I'm very impressed. A deserved winner, chapeau.